Tonight we have two artists whose work separately we have all grown up with. Not too many people you can say that about. Their work has stretched the boundaries of pop music in many ways, but the innovation has never gotten in the way of the songs always remaining heartfelt. Yes, you're right, it's Burt Bacharach and Elvis Costello. They've recently worked together on a whole album of original songs. It's a kind of historic collaboration, which to me seems completely natural. They're going to be doing, of course, some of the songs from that record tonight, and they're going to do some of the songs that they're famous for. Please welcome Burt Bacharach and Elvis Costello.
It's not the way you look that touch my heart. It's not the way you kiss that tears me apart. Oh, oh, oh. Many, many, many nights I've tried. I sit alone at home and I cry over you. What can I do? Can't help myself. 'Cause baby, it's you. Baby, it's you.
Will you please welcome Mr. Burt Bacharach?
Both of you have worked in popular music in a popular music form. Both of you grew up listening to jazz. You might be were listening to Ravel, Debussy.
Henry Cowell, starting with Henry Cowell here.
Yes, and exactly. Why then go, I'm going to take some of that, but I'm going to work in pop, I'm going to work in pop music. Why bother?
For me, you know, the choice of having studied with Darius Milhaud, Henry Cowell, Bohuslav Martineau, and having this chance to go that road, you know, to become a serious classical composer, whatever that means. I guess I didn't want to do it enough. It's also very hard to support yourself that way. You either have to wait for a grant from a symphony, from you have to teach at a university to supplement. I just like fresh orange juice in the morning too much, so, you know, it's, so I aspired to something. And it's hard, you know. I can never regret what I've done. Say, I could have written this great symphony or it's great. I can't talk that way at all because it was a choice. I'm so glad I did what I did.
You're in the same boat.
Well, I'm in the other way around, really, because I didn't study early on. I got exposed to all this music mainly through my parents' background in music and the different ways they were. My father, trumpet player and a singer. My mother, working just in retail in record shops. But at a time when you had to have a breadth of knowledge of repertoire that perhaps the modern record seller, with all due respect, doesn't have to have. So grew up in a household full of music, but no formal study until I was 35. And then only just enough to grasp the basics of notation, because everything that came into my head, I seemed to be able to communicate very well. But I was aware of the fact very quick, early on, that the music that I started with was going to kind of define me in a rather confine me if I wasn't careful. And I got curious about numerous other strains of music and tried to borrow from them sounds and instrumental colors and styles of composition. And more recently, sort of found myself working with classical musicians and jazz musicians in order to satisfy those things, or they came to me and asked me to take part in things. So it never really occurred to me that there was any real difference.
Many of the songs you're going to hear this evening are from a new record called Painted From Memory. And these are songs that Burt and I have been writing over the last 2 years. We were first introduced to write the song God Give Me Strength for a motion picture called Grace of My Heart. And we liked writing together, even though it was a very unusual introduction, using the telephone and the fax machine, as there was a deadline. And Burt lives in Los Angeles and I live in Dublin. Now, we got the bug after writing that song and we met up to record the tune. And one thing led to another. And the next thing, we found ourselves sitting around a piano, squabbling over the black notes and the white notes, and even the little spaces in between. But eventually we wrote 12 songs and made this record. And we decided that most of the songs on the record would be songs of lost love, different kinds of romantic song. And this song is one of the sadder ones, I would say. It's a man walking through deserted rooms in his house. It's called This House Is Empty Now.
Better
what you're after. You and your static again. Behind a brittle smile of a shrill laughter.
Thank you. About 21 years ago, before many of you were born, this gentleman here, this is Steve Nieve on the keyboard here. Steve Nieve. Steve Nieve and I were playing in a band called The Attractions, and we would occasionally... Steve and I were playing in a group called The Attractions, and occasionally we used to deviate from the script, and we would do a torch song or two, and in one particular Bacharach and David song we were very fond of, and we would like to perform it for you now with all of the correct changes.
I just don't know what to do with myself. I don't know just what to do with myself. I'm so used to doing everything with you, planning everything for two, and now I just don't know what to do with my time. I'm so lonesome for you. It's a crime. Going to a movie only makes me sad. Parties make me feel as bad when I'm not. Just don't know what to do. Like a summer rose needs the sun and rain. I need your sweet love to be all the things. Just don't know what to do with myself. Don't know just what to do with myself. Baby, if you knew love ever turns you down, come back, I will be around
just waiting for you. I just don't know what to do. I just don't know what to do.
The whole structure on both of your writing, musical writing, I'm mainly talking about now, mm-hmm. the arrangements are, I would say, part of the composing, part of the writing.
Always been this way for me. Once I was given permission to kind of protect my material and go and make my own records, whether I produced them or was brought in as an orchestrator, whether it was to do Blue on Blue with Bobby Vinton or go in and do Tommy Hunt or the Shirelles, or Chuck Jackson. Once I was given that green light, then, you know, what I always heard as I wrote these songs, there was an orchestration form. There was a rhythm pattern where the bass would play, where the drums, where the strings come in on the second eight, would you hold them out? So by the time the composition was done, 80% of that orchestration was in my head. If somebody else went in and did it, as what happened before I got that green light, I started producing records out of self-defense. I mean, a lot of they were pretty good songs that kind of went right down the drain because somebody else didn't want a three-bar phrase. They wanted a four-bar, so they added a bar, you know.
And so sometimes the producer also an artist,
oh, yeah.
in a sense?
Very often now. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've been very lucky, and I've had worked with excellent producers. I mean, I worked with Nick Lowe early on. The strange thing is that I don't want to give the impression when I say about learning to write music down has allowed me to kind of communicate and work with people, and I think it made our communication a lot easier than it would have been if I had been stumbling around on the piano with my limited technique, changing it every time
That'd
I played it.
You know,
that would have been frustrating. But that's not to suggest that the records that I started out with weren't orchestrated. Even they were just orchestrated for four instruments. You know, mm-hmm. like the point is often missed. And I know that lots of records I worked on early on have very definite ideas about what these sounds were supposed to represent. Sometimes they were imitation of classical instrumentation. We just didn't have access to it. We didn't have the ability to write it down. And it just develops in time. You gather more skills, and then you can be more precise in your direction.
This song is about a man who's looking, say, in the photograph that he carries in his wallet, and he cherishes it as if it were the finest painting. It's of a woman who's gone away, and he's trying to imagine life as it used to have been. It's called Painted from Memory.
Such a picture of loveliness. Didn't you notice the resemblance? Doesn't it look like she could speak? Those eyes I tried to capture, they you'd think that I would know by to capture their loss. To me now, forever, they smile for someone else. And so it's had to be painted from memory. She is gone, and I must accept it. She is lost to me now. But I can't look away just yet. Oh, she smiles for someone else.
Taylor.
The song we'd like to do for you now is comes from a while ago, and we're going to do it in a brand new arrangement written by Mr. Steve Nieve. It's maybe I should amend that to Steve Nieve, Love God. This is actually based on the very first performance of this song, which was in 1978 at Hollywood High School. Take us to it.
Says it went forever, it's now or never, but they keep him hanging on. This silly champion, she says she can't go home without a chaperone. Accidents will happen, we're all in run. You used to be a victim, now you're not the only one. Accidents will happen, we're all in run. I don't want to hear it, cause in the sea that only rise up in the sweat and smoke like mercury, and they keep you hanging on. They say you're so young, your mouth is made up, your mind is undone. Accidents will happen, we're all in wrong. You used to be a victim, now you're not the only one. Accidents will happen, we're all in run. I don't wanna hear it, cause I know what I've done.
check upon and add to your collection, but they keep you hanging on until you have gone. Your mind is made up, your mouth is undone. Accidents will happen, we're all in run. You used to be a victim, now you're not the only one. Accidents will happen, we're all in run. I don't want to hear it, cause
Mr. Steve Nieve. Take it back, Steve.
Do you think about there were people's relationships? When I was listening to the record, one thing that came to mind was I started thinking about people's relationships. I started thinking about, are we merely prisoners of our genetic propensities? Do men always do this? Do women always do this or want this?
I think the songs propose lots of different circumstances.
There's hope, too. Yeah. I mean, it's not like it's over. I mean, you listen to it, and maybe you can learn for the next time, you know? And you can benefit by what these beautiful words Elvis are saying, that, you know, well, I made that mistake, but, you know, the next time around, I ain't going to make that mistake because I recognize it. I think it's a lot of key audience identification that can be taken from this.
It's possible that people will see themselves in it, I think, in different ways. And as Burt said, it's not without hope that even the first song, In the Darkest Place, which has an ominous sounding title, is actually about somebody longing for there to be that little chink of light in the corner of an otherwise dark room. And it's the place that you sort of like, you're quite comfortable in there, quite enjoying the melancholy for a little while, and then, but you hope to revive from it. And the song My Thief talks about somebody having a dream of a lost lover, which they would rather have that haunting dream than no dream at all. So it's not without hope, it's just, it's gone, you know, the world has gone a little paler for them, you know, at times they feel it strongly, you know.
Just a cappella, just not singing it, just recite the last lines in My Thief, because...
The ones that Lisa sings?
Yeah, it's the killer.
So at the end of the song, My Thief concludes with the female voice singing. Lisa Taylor sings it on the record on stage. And it's the voice in the man's head where he's had this haunting dream, and she sings, I didn't lead you on, but there will always be a little larceny in everyone. So hush and don't you cry. I'm trying to be kind because I have the perfect alibi. So she has become like the agent of his torture, you know, in each sleepless or dreaming night. That's the lines that Burt referred to.
When I go to sleep, you become
Sometimes I pretend you'll come back again, and you'll console the heart you stole. Have pity on the man who knows that you have gone and has begun to break down. I feel almost possessed, so long as I don't lose this glorious distress, then you can take all I
Lisa Taylor. Lisa Taylor.
still have that other girl in my head. There may be ugly rumors that I have been lying. There may be angry tears, but they're never worth the crying. That is why sometimes I still have that other girl in my
why? And maybe I was washed out like a lip print on a shirt. See, I'm only human. I want him to hurt. I want him. I want him to the power to pretend that there could ever be a happy ending. That song is sung out. This bell is rung out. She was the light that I took my last chance of happiness. So God give me strength. God give me strength. Wipe her from my memory.